Now that we've created a Django project and an app to go with it, let's test our project and then commit the changes to Git. We're going to test our project using something called the Django development server. The Django development server is a very basic web server that's provided by Django for the purpose of testing our work as we go along. So we're going to start that server and we're going to test that our project is working correctly. Minimize Atom here and go over to the Git bash or the terminal window and make sure you're connected to our development server and you're working on the profiles API virtual environment. From this window, type cd /vagrant/src/profiles_project to change to our profiles project location. Type ls to see a list of the available files and directories that are in this directory. And you can see here that we have the manage.py file. Now the manage.py file is the file we used earlier to create our profiles API app. Now it's a file that's provided by Django for the Django project, and it has various helper functions in it that help us to work with our project. One of those is the run server command. The run server command is what we use to start our development server. So let's go ahead and type python manage.py run server, and then we need to tell it that we want it to listen on all network interfaces. We do that by typing 0.0.0.0. This means don't listen on any particular IP address, just listen on 0.0.0.0, which is all IP addresses. So all IP addresses on the server are going to be able to access this application when we run it. And then type colon, and then we're going to tell it to run on port 8080. So just to recap, the full command is python manage.py run server and then 0.0.0.0 colon 8080. So this says run our server, make it accessible on all IP addresses or all network interfaces on our server and run it on port 8080. Okay, so once we've typed that, we can hit enter to start our development server. You can see that it says that our server has been started and it's listening on the IP address that we said and the port that we said. So now let's connect to it and test that it's properly working. Load up Chrome and head over to 127.0.0.1:8080 and hit enter. You can see that it shows us this screen saying that it worked. The 127.0.0.1 address is the address for localhost. So because we're forwarding our port using Vagrant from the local machine to the development server, we can access the port 8080 on localhost. Let me just load up Atom and show you that in the Vagrant file so you can understand what I'm talking about. So this line here, where we forwarded the port, this forwards the port on our Vagrant server, the guest. So the guest is the Vagrant server because it's a guest to our main operating system. So it forwards the port 8080 to our host, which is our local operating system, 8080. So that means when we access 8080 on our local machine, it forwards this port into the server, and then we can test our development, our Django application on the development server. Okay, so now that we can see that we have a working Django app, let's commit our changes to Git. So we're gonna do that using a separate Git bash window. So come over here and type Git bash, or if you're on Mac, then you'll be using the terminal for this, but you'll have a separate terminal to the one on the one that's connected to our server. And then navigate to our project location. So cd workspace profiles rest API. And we're gonna type git add dot to add all of the new files. You'll only see this warning if you're on Windows. It's basically saying that it's converted the Windows line endings to Unix line endings when we added it. You don't need to worry about that command. It just converts it so that it's standard across all machines. Okay, so after typing git add, we're gonna type git commit hyphen am, and we're gonna give it the message added Django project and app and added requirements and hit enter. And then it's going to commit our changes to the project. If we head back to Atom, you see all these turn from green to gray to show that they've been committed. Okay, so that's how you test your application using the Django development server. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you found it useful, and I'll see you in the next lesson.